welcome to Space with Sarah. The Big Bang Theory sounds kind of crazy to some people. I'm often asked, is the Big Bang Theory valid? Followed by the question, what was there before? For the latter, I have no explanation, but I do agree it sounds kind of crazy that our whole universe was created in a Big Bang 13.8 billion years ago. The name the Big Bang actually came to be as a joke from a scientist supporting the theory of a steady, infinitely old universe. However, it stuck on, and there's actually a lot of evidence supporting the Big Bang theory. In several previous videos, we have discussed the expansion of space. The fact that the universe is expanding fits in very nicely with the hot Big Bang model, which states that the universe was once a lot smaller, hotter, and denser. The evidence that really put the nail in the coffin in favor of the Big Bang theory was the discovery of the cosmic microwave background in 1965. In any direction we look in the universe with a microwave antenna, we see radiation with a temperature of 2.7 degrees above absolute zero. The radiation is naturally explained if the universe was once a lot hotter and denser. In the early universe, all hydrogen atoms were ionized, meaning that their electrons weren't bound to their protons, but instead were floating around in a dense, hot, opaque plasma. This means that light particles, or photons, constantly had their paths deflected by banging against the electrons in the dense plasma. However, as the universe expanded and cooled, the electrons could be captured by the hydrogen nuclei to form hydrogen atoms. This happened when the universe was roughly 300,000 years old and had a temperature of 3,000 degrees. At this point in time, photons could travel in a free path and have done so ever since. The universe has expanded further since then, and now we measure these photons at a temperature of 2.7 degrees instead of 3,000 degrees. This temperature is constantly dropping as the universe expands further. The discovery of the cosmic microwave background was granted a Nobel Prize in Physics in 1978. A different piece of evidence for the Big Bang theory comes from the amount of hydrogen relative to helium. In the very early dense universe, the conditions were extreme enough for fusion to occur, where atomic nuclei fuse and form another element, for example, hydrogen to helium. The Big Bang theory predicts that enough fusion would have occurred to produce 25% helium by mass, leaving the universe with 75% hydrogen at its infant stage. In our current universe, some of this hydrogen and helium has been recycled in stars, as we heard about in a previous video. So we do expect heavier elements than hydrogen and helium, but in very small amounts. The prediction of 25% helium agrees with what we find when we look at the fraction of helium in stars. For example, the Sun has a helium fraction of 28%. The extra 3% of helium can be accounted for because the Sun formed when a lot of stars had already exploded and spread their heavier elements. This means that when the Sun formed, the universe already had a little extra helium. There's a lot of evidence for the Big Bang theory. While the theory might seem a little crazy, the evidence is pretty sound. Maybe our universe is just a little crazy. Thanks for watching Space with Sarah. If you're still curious about the universe, please subscribe to the channel. And as always, keep wondering.